Yes!
Yeah? What?
You've got unboxings to do!
Oh, yeah, I know! Just, you know, have a little private time with the pinball. I know it. I'll be right there.
You gotta do them now!
Okay. I'll do the unboxing just as long as it's not something stupid like a giant colossal. I'm sick of those.
It happened again, didn't it? They made another one. Max has left me. It happened again, of course. They never seem to stop making them. I don't know why. They just want to fill landfills with plastic. Or your house with plastic. Big lumps of plastic that you can't do anything with. It's ridiculous. Anyway, presenting the new colossal thingy that they've made. Beautiful assistant. Gimme. Oh, there we go. Look at it. The Indoraptor. Isn't it massive? Doesn't it not need to be this big? Yeah, here we are. Here we go again on my own. Why, Mattel? Why? You knew I'd have to do this. You knew for the views. So here we are. We've got this freaking absolutely ginormous, it's gigantic bite, Indoraptor. They're having to put things on crowdfunding. Yeah, they can make this. Put the money into the good stuff. Do we have a look at the back of the box? You've got the Indoraptor there. So just showing, well, what it does. That is what every other colossal does. Eat. And it eats little toys. It has a little hatch on the bottom, I'm assuming. So without further ado, let's break into it, shall we? Upsies, maxies, up. He's a good boy, yeah! Oh, who cares about that? Look at Mixie! Say hello to your adoring public Max! How big are you? Are you the size of a colossal?
No.
Look at this, what's this? That's scissors. What's this, Mixie? What's that?
I have no idea. Stop asking me.
He's a cutie, yes!
I love you so much!
He's like, oh my god. I don't want to be in this relationship anymore. Can you do it? Right, Max, I don't have any scalpels. Right, okay, we're gonna have to do this the old-fashioned way. Oh, come on. Okay, this is ridiculous. Because they made it look like if you take off the sellotape, you can just easy, like, take it apart, but you can't. I don't have time for that! Alright, there it is! There's your Indoraptor. Beautiful. If you enjoyed this video, guys, where's the rest of you? Let's stick your leg on. The legs that you can't take apart once you put them on, which means it's going to take up loads of space once you do this.
Why are we still here?
Go on, Whitney. Get a good shot of that. We can put that on the OnlyFans and get loads of money. Wouldn't be surprised if there's someone who does that. Every Mattel dinosaur toys foot pictures. Okay. There we have it. We have an Indoraptor. Colossal Indoraptor. What? I know why they've done it. I just don't really agree with it. It's a ginormous another one. I mean, what can I say about it? I mean, it's an Indoraptor. It's the most basic kind of dinosaur as far as like complexity goes. It's basically just black. So I can't even really comment on the paint job, if I'm gonna be honest. But one thing I will comment on is the posture. So you can actually rotate the arms and the claws, because remember, actual raptors had claws like that would like face out like clappers. But Jurassic Park raptors, you'd have to break bone, as Jim Kirkland would say, in order to do that. And now he just looks a bit handsy. wait. And weirdly, you know, the Indoraptor was one of the dinosaurs in the Jurassic franchise that could do quadrupedal and bipedal walking. It would sort of run on all fours and then stand on two limbs at some points. But for some odd reason, they've decided with this one, probably because it's easier, if we're gonna be honest, to just have it stand on two legs. Because I don't know, because its body is not long enough, really, to get down on the floor, like, and there's no way you can pivot from the ankle. I mean, you can twist the ankle just to get some. There you go. Now it's complete. Okay, so what else can you do? Okay, so you've got the rotating forearms, I guess, or hands. You've got some clippy clips of the mouth. I mean, you've got its almost like gharial teeth there that are sort of going in and out of each other's jaws. The one strange thing, and it's probably a cost-saving feature about this, is that they've done the mouth red, which of course makes sense. But I don't know if it's an oversight, but if you look at the back of the head, you can see like the inside of its head. Sculpt is great. Paint job, can't really comment on. Although for some reason, and I think it's deliberate, they've decided to put some glitter on the Indoraptor. If you just zoom into its head, it's almost like it's like a marble, a galaxy marble that you'd find in your kitchen, a counter table. But the rest of it doesn't. Although, anyway, it kind of glistens in the light because it's this sort of reflective kind of plastic. Tail, of course, bends and sort of clips into place on the right and the left. Doesn't move up and down. Articulation's not really too great, but it definitely is the head of the Indoraptor. Very faithful sculpt. So I can give it some praise for that. If there's one thing that Colossals do get right, it's the sculpt. I'd say I would complain about the toenails being painted like we did with Giganotosaurus. However, because the whole thing's black plastic anyway and the nails would be black, well, you win this time. What else to say? You've got the weird flippy. It's not wrong. This is how you play with it. You've got its little feature of the flap. They all have it. It always looks like this. Again, this whole thing started with the Lost World T-Rex. The Lost World T-Rex. This is the bull or buck T-Rex. Basically, this singular toy from Kenner from 1997 inspired the entire Colossal range because it can open its mouth wide, but Mattel has an aversion to rubber. So they were like, no, we're gonna do solid plastic. And again, rubber, not only can you, you know, whatever you want to it to fit whatever goes inside, it also sort of has like a C-section, I suppose. Not really screen accurate. Head is beautiful, but the rest of the body is out of proportion. Massive feet to accommodate for the weight, but the length of the body is too short and the tail especially is too short. But you compare that to the freaking buck T-Rex, we're on a whole nother level. So there's only one thing left to do now that we've got a new addition to the family. Welcome to the family. I get the family. Wow, Mattel really splurged out for your feet there. Wow. Come on, where are you, Brachiosaurus? But wait, there's more. Oh, the T-Rex is longer. Like just by like a little bit. All right, then we can get them all on the table, surely. But they've had a sort, you know, they've actually released a Mementosaurus as well, I think, or Dreadnoughtus. I think there's Dreadnoughtus, Mementosaur, Apatosaur, Brachiosaur. Stop with it! You've got a problem, Mattel! Stop your weird obsession! Did you just say, why don't I stop buying them? Hi. There is nothing I can't even display this. Show the obsession, Whitney! Show the problem! Colossal Brachiosaur, Colossal Toast. Colossal Indoraptor, Colossal Giganotosaurus, Colossal T-Rex, Colossal Apatosaur. That's not even including Colossal Blue, Colosso Indominus Rex, Colossal Dreadnoughtus, Colossal Mementosaurus, the John Hammond collection. Brachiosaur, which is probably the same size as this Brachiosaur, but it's got a different sculpt on the head, which means we have to buy. Guys, do I stop doing these? Please tell me. Because this will get lots of views. So I kind of can't stop doing it. Yeah, actually, you know what? That's a thing. Yes. I'm very curious, everyone. Do you actually collect these? And if you do, what do you do with them? I'd love to know storage, because I had people sending me in their dinosaur collections, and a lot of people maybe had one or two. People are just waiting for their favorite dinosaur to become a colossal. It's a great painting project, but as far as, I don't know, things on shelves go, you need a whole room for these. Dinosaur collection is not what it used to be. I think in the end, we're just gonna have to do a battle royale, every colossal just like smashing against each other until one breaks. And there can only be one winner. Who's the strongest coloss? Because some of them do feel really hollow. Like the plastic in some is really brittle, and others my bet would be on the Apatosaur. I think the Apatosaur would last. It would stand the test of time. Well, anyway, guys, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't know if it's even been long or even worth it, if I'm honest. If you enjoyed it, leave a like, and until next time, I'll see you guys later. Bye.
You could have just let that one go, couldn't you?
No, it didn't really good. But look at it. I did the T-Rex chase and I got such a high score. Hold on, what am I on? I haven't even checked it. I've had this ball for ages. I got a replay, look at that. I've never had a replay before. But look, I just got a... Should we do system boot?
System boot.
That's, I like when he says that. Right, here we go. We're doing good. All I need to do is just get up a ramp. Like that almost. Except for, here we go. Okay, that was a different ramp. Didn't realize. Okay, there's one. That's one system. We've got 2x scoring on the field. No, I did a stupid.
Fine, I'll do it.